Welcome learners, I'm Dr. Pallavi Kaul and today we will know about planning for integrated learning. In this section, let us understand the process of planning for integration, planning for integration in the subject, among the subject and beyond the subjects. Let us know the planning for integration within the subject area. Have you ever thought of combining or integrating different concepts related to a topic while teaching a particular subject in a class? Suppose you are teaching living and non-living beings in science to class 6 students. There are so many concepts which are related to the topic, like difference between living and non-living on the basis of reproduction, movement, food and metabolism, etc. And other concepts such as ecological balance among different types of living beings, depletion and conservation of natural resources related to the growth in population of living being, etc. All are related. You can observe that the learning objective of one topic may have some sort of relation with those of another topic of the same subject. If such related concepts could be regrouped, the learner can have a more holistic and meaningful learning of the issue or topic that is being discussed in the class. To avoid repetition in learning and to make learning more meaningful, it is better to link different competencies even in the same subject. While preparing the integrated plan within a subject, following steps may be considered. First, determine the distinctive nature of learning in each subject area. Determine the competencies or outcomes of learning in each topic under the specific subject area. Identify knowledge and skills. We mean by that competencies and outcomes of learning which are connected to the topic that you are planning to teach. And then plan learning experiences for teaching of the topic which need to be connected closely to the real life experiences of the student as far as possible. For example, in the subject EVS of class 2, the following steps and process have been illustrated as shown in the table 2 to indicate integration of the concepts. The plan is a sample of integrated approach of planning process. Now let us take this topic, village festival, the integration of family with my neighborhood. Competencies which are required are identifying the work of different family members. The second competency is activities of the students to help the family. Third is identifying the importance of neighborhood. And the next is recognizing the different social institutions. Now the process of integrating the competencies can be done by asking few questions or doing certain activities. For example, here we can ask few questions like, what do you see in the village festival? Who organizes the work? Do all the members of village do same thing in the festival? State the name of the family member and what they do in daytime. Do all do same or different work? If different, who does what? What do you do at home? Who helps you in doing your work? How do you help others at home? Describe the help you receive from outside your family. Name the persons, places or the organizations from which you get support. Discuss in group to name the places he or she has seen, for example, market, hospital, post office, etc. Discuss group wise about the functions of different places and institutions. Keeping intact purpose of integration as a result of which the desired competencies can be attained. We plan the steps of integration as per our suitability. Now let us discuss the next type of planning for integration. Integration different subject areas, that is multidisciplinary integration. You will agree that in each class, each subject is taught following separate and specific methods supposed to be appropriate to the nature of the subject. For example, induction is typically used only in mathematics, storytelling in history, and nature observation in science and EVS. However, do you think that storytelling can also be used to make mathematics teaching more interesting for students in the early grades? Using different methods with flexibility would help us not only in making the lesson more interesting for the student, but also in integrating different subjects meaningfully. There are linkages among the different subjects regarding their competencies or learning outcomes. We need to link the topics of different subjects in a particular class for effective learning and to avoid repetition. Let us discuss some strategies of preparing integrated plan in which the following may be considered. Bring together topic, themes, issues or big ideas and learning outcomes for more than one subject area, keeping the subject specific outcomes distinct. Knowledge and skills are learned through individual subject areas, but at times connect to cross-curricular topic, themes, issue or big ideas. Determine the distinctive nature of learning and effective methods of learning in each subject area. Examine the possibility of combining concepts from different subject areas through an integrating method of learning and or teaching. The students are guided to see linkages between the subject areas. As an illustration, observe the outline of an integrated plan for the subject like language, environmental studies and mathematics of class 2 given in the table 3 on your screen. Now here the topic being discussed is the story of Aruni. The competencies in the language subject are reading the story with correct pronunciation. The second one is make question to get the answer. Next one is read the picture and describe the story. Now for these, the process of integrating different subject, what we can do is we can make student to sit in a circle and tell the story and following the appropriate storytelling method. Make small size group of students for them to prepare questions, intergroup interaction and correction. Now in the EVS subject, we see that described about different season and especially rainy season. So this kind of competency can be developed in the EVS. Name the crop cultivated during the rainy season. Name the instrument used for cultivation. Differentiate between the groundwater and the rainwater. Say the cause of water pollution and common diseases during rainy season. Now for this, for to develop these competencies, the process of integrating the different subject area, we can do certain activities like we can make the students to arrange the pictures sequentially about the various seasons. Now supplying the situational picture to describe the story. So different pictures will be given to the students and these pictures they will arrange sequentially according to the story that how different seasons are coming one after the other. The student can also can be made to describe their feelings in the rainy season. The students can be asked to describe the crops cultivated in the various seasons. List out the use of instruments for cultivation. For example, whatever instruments they know which are being used traditionally and what are the various modern technologies. They can even differentiate the quality of groundwater and rainwater. Then they can discuss about the rainwater pollution and the common diseases due to this pollution. Now, integration of mathematics can be done by talking about geometrical shapes of the crop fields. This competencies can be developed. Another competency which can be developed is measures non-standard unit of water container, subtraction through objects. Now for this, we can ask the students to discuss on the geometrical shapes related to the crop field. Discuss about the different measures of both types, standard and non-standard measures. Then they can draw a freehand sketch of a map of different sizes of the crop field. Then they can list the different types of non-standard units found to be used in their own locality. Now we can see in this example that the integrated plan can be more effective if this activity-based approach discussed earlier in the Unit 4 of Block 1 is used in the classroom transaction, keeping the desired competencies in view. Now, let us know about the third type of planning for integration, that is interdisciplinary integration, that is integration between the different subject areas. The interdisciplinary integration is somewhat similar to the multidisciplinary integration. In multidisciplinary integration, some linkages among the different subjects are identified and connected for integrated planning. But in interdisciplinary integration, independent or common knowledge and skills from different subjects are identified and integrated for planning and transaction purposes. The following steps may be followed for planning interdisciplinary integration. Topic, themes, issues, or big ideas and learning outcomes are identified from more than one subject area. The common learning outcomes are then identified. The knowledge and skills are learned beyond the immediate lessons. The students are guided to acquire the curricular knowledge and skills through integrated approach of learning. In the process of interdisciplinary integration, the concepts and skills from different subject areas, disciplines are combined for strengthening a core skill or competencies. The learning outcome, skill or competency forms the core around which the relevant concepts from various subjects are arranged to strengthen it in the most natural way connected to the real life experiences of the student as far as possible. A diagrammatic representation of the interdisciplinary integration is presented in the figure on the screen. So we see here that the numeracy skills are connected to EVS through the concept of population. It is connected to mathematics when we are teaching them number and operation on the numbers. In geography, we are connected the numeracy skills when we are teaching them about the longitude and the latitude. We can teach meter of a poem in the literature subject in English. In history, we can talk about the numeracy skills using the timeline. And in science, the concept of motion can be taught using the numeracy skills. And in EVS, population can be taught using the numeracy skill. Notice that the planning process of the interdisciplinary integration is similar to that of the multidisciplinary integration. Almost all the learning experiences provided in the classroom and school is based on the curricular subjects and textbook on those subjects. But as we all know, there is unlimited scope available and in and out of the school for learning not only the intended curricular outcomes but also much more than those. If we can expose our students to those experiences, their learning can be strengthened and enriched. There are innumerable ways of integrating those experiences in building a holistic plan for learning of children at different level of schooling. Here are some suggestions as to how you can go about it. Have the list of competencies, learning outcomes of each subject of each class normally available in the school ready with you. Plan the co-scholastic activity with regular intervals. These should include participation in local festivals, observation of important social and cultural function, visit to market and other important places or institutions in the locality, conducting various cultural activities in the school, witnessing games, sports and other entertaining events. So we see that these things happen in most of the schools. Before the student joins these events, list the skill, competencies and learning outcomes the student can acquire from these events. The list has to be finalized in consultation with the student and may contain the learning outcomes from more than one subject area. Here the skills and competencies are more important than the subjects. After the students come back from the events, have a discussion with the student regarding the new knowledge or experiences they have acquired besides the earlier planned outcomes. On most occasion, you will find students have acquired much beyond the planned outcomes. After the discussion, request the student to prepare a brief report of their experiences gained from the event. This would not only enhance their composition abilities, but would help them to reflect upon their gains and would further help them to sustain the gains, making learning more meaningful while reinforcing the curricular learning outcomes, acquiring more skills and competencies than planned, making learning more contextual and real-life related, realizing that every situation, be in school or outside the school, is a source of learning, and strengthening the belief that learning is a continuous process, not confined only to the confines of the school and curriculum. So friends, with this, we have come to the end of this session. See you in the next session. Thank you.